Hello friends, we are going to talk about section formula in coordinate geometry in this session. Hello friends, so now let's understand what do we mean by section formula. We already know the distance formula by which we can find out the distance between two points whose coordinates are given to us. Now let's see what do we get by the section formula. Now if the coordinates of two points A and B are given to us, the points being x1, y1 and x2, y2, and these two points are internally divided in the ratio m is to n by a point P, then we can find out the coordinates of this point P using the section formula, and the coordinates would be given by x equal to mx2 plus nx1 divided by m plus n, and y will be m equal to my2 plus ny1 divided by m plus n. So this is what the section formula says. Now, if we have this diagram where we have this point A and the point B, and we want to find out the coordinate of this point P, which is represented by xy, such that it divides the line AB in the ratio m is to n, such that AP is m and BP is n. So now we want to find out the coordinates of this point. Now let's see how do we reach this formula. Now in this figure we have this triangle AQP and we have PRB. Now what are these triangles? We drop a perpendicular from point B on the x-axis. We drop a perpendicular which meets this from the perpendicular from B on the x-axis meets the axis at the point D. We drop a perpendicular from A on the x-axis which meets it at point C, and we drop a perpendicular from point P on the x-axis again. Now we draw this perpendicular from A on the line BD which meets BD at point E, and similarly we drop a perpendicular from point P to BD which meets it at point R. So we have now PR being perpendicular to BD and similarly AE being perpendicular to BD. So we are saying these two are 90 degree, and of course these were all 90 degree. Now we are talking about the triangle AQP and PRB. So these two triangles that we're talking about, now we know that these the angle Q in this triangle and the angle R in this triangle are equal. Alright? And now we have AC is parallel to PQ and this is parallel to BD. So now in this we know that AB is basically a transversal to these parallel lines. So based on that we can say that this angle APQ will be equal to angle PBR. So, and this angle we've already said is 90 degree, the angle AQP and angle PRB. So, two angles being equal, the third angle will be equal. So, by AA criteria, AAA, angle criteria, these two triangles have to be similar, which would mean m by n will be equal to x minus x1, which is AQ. AQ is nothing but x minus x1 and x2 minus x is nothing but PR. So we are saying we are simply using the the similarity of these two triangles, which states that the ratio of the three sides will be equal. So AP being M and PB being N. So we are saying AP by PB is equal to AQ by PR, and that will be equal to PQ, which is Y minus Y1 divided by BR, which is Y2 minus Y. So we have this. Now, if we solve for X and Y, we'll take these two. We'll take the first two equality terms to solve for X, and we'll take the first and the third term of equality to solve for Y. So if we solve this, we get X is equal to MX2 plus NX1 divided by M plus N, and Y is equal to MY2 plus NY1 divided by M plus N. Now, if we are saying we have to find out the midpoint of the side AB, where A and B coordinates are given to us, we know M and N are both 1. So, now that point, the midpoint of this would become simply X1 plus X2 by 2 will be the abscissa of the midpoint, and Y1 plus Y2 by 2 will be the ordinate of the midpoint of the given two points. So now let's see if we have to find the coordinates of a point which is dividing the line segment joining A and B externally in the ratio of M by M is to N. Now this is given by this formula: X is equal to MX2 minus NX1 by M minus N, and Y is equal to MY2 minus NY1 divided by M minus N. So the only difference between the internally dividing ratio in M is to N and externally dividing is this sign, which has now become negative. We'll again see how do we arrive at this formula. Now we have this diagram where we have these two points A and B, and now here we are saying AP, which is this divided by BP is M by N. Now in this figure we again draw the same perpendiculars to the x-axis, and then from point A and B, we draw perpendiculars to PD such that these are all right angles. Now we'll take the triangles AEP, the bigger one, and BRP, the smaller one. This one and then the bigger one. So in this again, we see that AC is parallel to BQ, which is parallel to PE, and these being parallel and AP acting as the transversal, we can clearly see that this angle will be equal to this angle. This angle in fact would be common in triangle BPR and APE, and the right angle we know is AEP and BRP. So these two angles again become similar using the same proportionality theorem for the similar triangles. We say M by N is equal to M by N. M is AP. Now this we are saying again is AP by BP will be equal to X minus X1, which is AE. By X minus X2, which is nothing but BR. And similarly, that will be equal to Y minus Y1, which is PE, divided by Y minus Y2, which is PR. So this is just the basic proportionality theorem that we've used for similar triangles. And now we again solve for X using the first two terms of equality. And for solving for y, we will take the first and the third term of equality. So we get x is equal to mx2 minus nx1 divided by m minus n, and y is equal to my2 minus ny1 divided by m minus n. Now let's see, where is the section formula used? The obvious use is finding out the point which divides the segment in the given ratio, or finding out what is the ratio that a given point is dividing the line segment in. So the two things are that if we have these two points given to us, we want to find out this point P which will divide this line in the ratio of, say, 3:2. The other possibility is that we know this point and we have to find out what is the ratio that this line AB gets divided into by the point P. So we have the coordinates of all the three points given, then we can find out the ratio. If we have coordinates of A and B given and the ratio given, we can find out the coordinates of P. Besides this, there are other uses of section formula. We can find out the type of quadrilateral by checking whether the midpoint of the diagonals are the same or not. Right? So if we find out that if we have a quadrilateral whose diagonals intersect at the midpoint, that means the diagonals bisect each other, then we'll be able to find out the type of quadrilateral and we'll be able to rule out the other types. So say for example, we have a kite. The diagonals of the kite do not bisect each other. So we'll know that we can find out the type of quadrilateral. We can find the unknown vertex of the quadrilateral whose type is given to us. Now supposing we have three vertex of a rectangle provided to us. Now we can find out this coordinate by using the section formula. Or maybe distance formula. So this is a rectangle that I am taking. In certain cases, even section formula would be helpful in finding out unknown vertex. We can find out the centroid of the triangle using the section formula, because centroid, we know the two centroids of the triangle. The centroid of the triangle divides the median in the ratio 2:1. So knowing this, if we know the vertex of the triangle, all the three vertices of the triangle, we can find out the centroid of this triangle using the section formula. So there are many other uses where this is put to use. Friends, I hope you enjoyed the session. If you find it useful, please like it and share it with your friends. You can visit us at our Cool Smart Learning website and post your queries there. And please subscribe to the Cool Smart Learning channel for getting updates on the new sessions. Thank you.